Hey guys, today I'm gonna give you some tips on finishing the game with a starter weapon, so you will get the what there is nothing wrong with these trophy or achievement. Welcome, I am Xander from GamesGrid Network, where I'm obsessed to help you out with your games, and I'm going to explain how you can easily beat the game with the starter weapon. First, I'm going to show you how you can get the starting weapons. If you already have the random starting weapons, you can still get the original starting weapons, because those three you will need to finish the game with in order to get the trophy or achievement. So the random starting weapons don't count. Second, I will give you some tips on how you can make your run easier by mixing the starting weapon with a good build. And after that, you can watch my full run if you're interested on how I got to the end and finished the game with the starting weapon. When you first start the game, you want to go from your spawn and pick up a weapon and go back to where you drop down, and you see the wall rune under the platform and break them with your weapon. On the right you get the beginner's bow, and on the left you will get the rusty sword, and above it by the small platforms you will get the old wooden shield. What I recommend is not to use the old wooden shield for this one, because shields are mostly good because of their bonuses. But this one doesn't have any bonuses, so it's just plain useless. So that leaves you two choices, that's the rusty sword and a beginner's bow. I use the beginner's bow because I am using a tactics build, so the bow's damage will scale with it and it will still do good damage throughout the whole run, so it isn't complete useless. As for the rusty sword, if you go a brutality build, this weapon can do good damage as well, but putting yourself in harm's way by standing close to the enemy with a sword with no special abilities may get you killed. As for my build, I used the beginner's bow, the ice bow, and the heavy turret, and the cross-o-matic turret. What I want to do with this build is powering up your tactic stats to the highest level possible within the run, and upgrade the weapon so you will get the maximum damage output within the run. And as you can see, you can also upgrade the beginner's bow once to add 25% more damage. As for the route I took, from the prisoner's quarters to the promenade of the condemned, and from there I went to the prisoner's depths, and after that I went to the Asuri level and defeated the boss after that level, and from there I went to the slumbering sanctuary and I took the route to the clock tower from there, and after that it is just a straight way forward to the timekeeper boss in the clock room, High Peak Castle, and as final the throne room, where I have to fight the Hand of the King. I got this route from a commenter, what is really good, so shout out to the commenter. Now I will show you the full run if you're interested in it, but it has no commentary, so it's just plain focus on the run, how I got my power up, weapons, and how I beat the enemies within the run, so you can see how I did it, and how I got the trophy and achievement, so enjoy if you would like to watch. Let's go.
Thank you. Thank you.
So that wraps up the video. I thank you guys for watching. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you want more gaming videos like this one, then you could subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you don't miss anything. But that is it for today. I catch you guys next time.